Welcome to the counterparty's email. The sign-up page is here. It's just a matter of checking the box if you're already registered on the Reuters website. Send suggestions, story tips and complaints to counterparties.reuters@gmail.com. During Angela Merkel's six-hour visit to Athens today, her first in 3 years, she was officially given the red carpet treatment, writers Noah Barkin and Harry Papakris to write. The purpose of her trip was a symbolic show of support for Prime Minister Antonis Samaras and his government's reforms aimed at turning around the country's battered economy. Ordinary Greeks seemed intent on producing a thank you for trying verbose. This recording will go away once the product has been purchased. Different kind of symbolism. Tens of thousands of demonstrators defied a ban on protests, gathering in Centerville Square to voice their displeasure with the German leader, who many blamed for forcing painful cuts on Greece in exchange for two EU IMF bailout packages worth over 200 billion euros. Some pelted police with rocks, bottles and sticks, and tried to bust through the barricade set up to protect Merkel and her delegation. Some 7,000 police were needed to control an estimated 50,000 protesters, some of whom burned Nazi flags or clashed with police. Thank you for trying verbose. This recording will go away once the product has been purchased. As usual, The Guardian's excellent live blog has full details on the day's events. Merkel attempted to convince Greeks that she understood there were many people suffering in Greece due to EU-mandated austerity measures, and said she hoped and wished that Greece would stay in the Eurozone. That optimistic message was undercut by a new IMF report that reduced the fund's projected 2013 growth rates for advanced economies to 1.5% from 2%, and highlighted the issues that remain unresolved among Eurozone members. The report's title, Coping with High Debt and Sluggish Growth, pretty much says it. Thank you for trying verbose. This recording will go away once the product has been purchased. All. In terms of economic policy, the IMF growth forecast assumes the U.S. will prevent itself from falling off the fiscal cliff, that Eurozone crisis measures will be effective, and that long-term solutions to thorny issues like fiscal transfers and a banking union will be achieved.